More than 500,000 people have been reported missing in the U.S. since 2021. And people of color make up 38% of that number, even though Black people only make up 13% of the population. But when we turn on the news, we rarely see our missing loved ones featured as the lead story. Joining me now to talk about this is Natalie Wilson. She's co-founder of the Black and Missing Foundation Incorporated. So, Natalie, tell me, why did you decide to dedicate your life's work to this mission?
Hi, Eboni, and thank you so much for having me. We decided to create the foundation because there were hundreds of thousands of persons of color reported missing, and they weren't getting any type of media coverage and law enforcement resources at all. So I wanted to use my experience, my expertise in media relations to really be the publicist for these families so that our missing can be household names too. You know, if you ask anyone to name a missing person, they'll say Chandra Levy, Kaylee Anthony, and the list goes on and on. Most recently, Gabby Petito. But I ask your viewers to list one person of color that has gotten that same level of media coverage, and they can't. And sadly, these cases are going under the radar.
Now, Natalie, we could speculate, but you do this work on a daily basis. You're exactly right. Myself, coming from national news background, every time we see a lead story around a missing person, it's almost always a blonde, white, young woman or girl, almost always. Mm-hmm. Why is there such disparity and discrepancy in the coverage of Black people?
Well, sadly, race and income level is a barrier to media coverage and law enforcement resources. And as I mentioned earlier, we want our missing to be household names too. Yeah. Oftentimes when our children are reported missing, well, guess what? Law enforcement classifies them as a runaway. So if you're classified as a runaway, you do not get the Amber Alert or any type of media coverage at all. And our young girls tend to be adultified. You know, they're fast. They're getting what they deserve. No, these are our children, our mothers, our daughters, our sisters, and they need to be protected. And we need to change the narrative around this.
Indeed. I'm glad you said that, Natalie. As unfortunate of a fact as it is, it's true. The data supports that young Black girls, just like young Black boys, are erroneously aged according to their appearance. On average, I want to say the last numbers I saw said that 4 to 5 years are added to a young Black girl's age, and the same with young Black boys. And the consequences of that, the hypersexualization that goes on, the adultification, they're dire. Natalie, right now we see that there's nearly 140,000 missing kids of color under the age of 18. They're kids. How do we help bring them home?
We help bring them home by sharing their information. You know, we want the community to be our digital milk carton. Just because you don't know the missing child or individual, just don't disregard it. Share it. Help these cases to go viral. And that's how Gabby Petito family, you know, used her media exposure to help bring awareness to her case. And I'll tell you, media coverage, social media coverage is so vital because it also puts pressure on law enforcement to add resources to the case. And it brings us in the community to spring into action because we tend to sit back and we don't know that this is an issue affecting our communities. You know, when we're talking to our community about sex trafficking, they're like, oh, it's not happening here. It's happening abroad. No, it's happening in our backyard. And since the pandemic, our caseload has doubled because we're spending time online and the predators are spending time online. So let's protect our children and share this information and have those tough conversations with them about internet safety, about being safe as well.
Now, quickly, before we go to break, Natalie, you mentioned sex trafficking, and it's so important. We've seen data that says that these traffickers believe that they will get less prison time. They will be less punished for the trafficking of young Black girls versus that of white girls and children. How do we get these traffickers behind bars?
We have to take this issue seriously, but we also have to change the laws. You know, this is an election year, and let's elect people, leaders that have our interests at heart.
Absolutely.
I know that Maryland has a safe harbor law. So when these children are forced into sex trafficking, they're not thrown into jail. They're given the resources to be rehabilitated. But we can't do this work alone. We have to use our power to vote to protect our children.
Now, still to come, we've got some tips to help keep your kids safe this Halloween.